You probably have lots of folders and files on your SharePoint sites that contain lots of valuable information. How do you make all of those insights available to people throughout your organization? In this video, we'll look at a brand new feature called Agents in SharePoint, which is available starting today. With it, you can select sites, folders, or files, and with just a few clicks of the mouse, you can create an AI agent and then you can share it, say for example in Microsoft Teams, and it'll answer people's questions. It's really easy to set up, so let's dive in. To be able to create a SharePoint agent, first off, we need to get to SharePoint. Log into Microsoft365.com. Then, in the top left-hand corner, let's click on the waffle icon, or what's also known as the app launcher. And here, you'll see all of your different apps. Let's click on SharePoint. This drops us on the SharePoint homepage, and here you can get back to all of your different SharePoint sites. Navigate to the site that you would like to add an agent to. I'd like to add an agent to the Kevin Cookie Company Hub. We use this site to store all of our most important documents for employees, like our recipes, our employee handbook, prices, and also customer orders. I'll click on this one. Every SharePoint site now comes with a pre-made Copilot that's scoped to all of the content stored on this SharePoint site. Let's test this out. In the top right-hand corner, let's click on this Copilot icon. This opens up the Copilot pane over on the right-hand side. And if you've used Copilot in Outlook, Word, Excel, or PowerPoint, this probably looks very familiar. Right at the top, I have some example prompts that I could start with. And down at the bottom, we have a text field where I can ask a question about this SharePoint site. Let's test this out. I've had a burning question in mind for a long time about the Kevin Cookie Company. How many free cookies do employees get each week? I know there's a document somewhere that has that information, but let's see if the Copilot can pull that out. In the bottom right, I'll click on this to send it to the AI. What an amazing benefit! Here it looks like each employee at the Kevin Cookie Company receives 5 free cookies per week. That must be why our employee satisfaction is so high. If you run a company, you should try this, preferably with Kevin Cookie Company cookies. One of the really neat things, at the end, we see a citation for where it got this information from. If I hover over this number, it tells me that it found it in the employee handbook, and it also found it in the all hands deck that management shared with employees. This works great if you have questions about this specific SharePoint site and all of the files contained within, but you might also want to scope your interaction with the AI to multiple SharePoint sites, or maybe specific folders, or just individual files. To do that, we can set up what's called a custom agent. Over on the left-hand side, let's click into Documents. This drops us into the Documents, and this shows all the different files that I have stored on this SharePoint site. We get questions all the time from customers asking us about the ingredients in our cookies, how much we charge for our cookies, and sometimes they ask about order status. Our employees spend a lot of time answering those questions, so I'd like to see if maybe I could have Copilot simply answer all of those. At least that way we could help the staff and make them a little bit more efficient. I think what would be relevant is here I have cookie recipes. Let me select this. If we go down a little bit more, I have a price list. And I also have status on customer orders. I'll select these 3 files. You can select up to 20 different items, and Copilot currently supports most file formats, with more coming soon. To create an agent, there are 2 different ways you can do this. Once you select your files, up on top, you can click on this button that says Create an Agent, or alternatively, simply go down to one of the files that you have highlighted, click on the 3 dots, and right here, you'll also see an option to Create an Agent. Let's click on this. And look at that, we now have an agent. Like I said, it's really easy to set one up. Of course, we probably want to make a few tweaks. If we look up above, the name of this agent is Documents Agent. That's not very descriptive. In the bottom right-hand corner, to continue refining this agent, let's click on this Edit button. This drops us on a screen where we can edit the agent's identity, the sources, and the behavior. Let's start with the identity by giving this agent a better name. Right here, I'm going to call it Common Customer Questions Answered. Down below, we can also set an image for this agent. Let's click on Change. Let's choose this picture of milk and cookies. I'll double-click on that, and that's now assigned it to my agent. At the very bottom, I can also describe this agent and what the purpose is. Over here, let's type in some text, a helpful virtual assistant that quickly answers common customer questions. Up above, let's now switch into sources. Within sources, you can add additional sources. For example, let's say you also want to include another SharePoint site. You could type that in here, and you could also include additional files. However, I'm happy with all of the files that I already selected. Up on top, let's switch into behavior. On the right-hand side of the behavior screen, you can see an example of what this agent will look like when users interact with it. I'd like to modify the welcome message as well as some of the sample prompts. Over on the left-hand side, I can do that. Right here, I'll type in a different welcome message, and here I'll change some of the starter prompts. For example, how much does a chocolate chip cookie cost? Do any of our cookies have nuts? And what's the status of the cookie order? Down at the very bottom, I can also type in instructions for the agent. Down here, it says provide accurate information about the content in the selected files. That sounds good, but it says reply in a formal tone. We're a cookie company and we don't do formal, so let's change that. Instead, let's use a casual tone. That makes a big difference. Down at the very bottom, you also have the option to add advanced customization in Copilot Studio. Let's say, for example, that you want to connect to your CRM, let's say a database, or maybe other systems, you can do that. That's beyond the scope of this video. I'm now all done making modifications. At the bottom, let's click on Save. Then, in the top right, let's click on the X to close out of this view. Over on the right-hand side, we can now interact with the agents that we just created. If you click on this dropdown, you can see all the different agents on this SharePoint site. Let's start by clicking on the starter prompt. Do any of our cookies have nuts? I'll click on this, and that populates a text field down below. Let's send it through. Who would have guessed? Our peanut butter cookies have nuts in them. If we look over at the document list, you might have noticed that there's now a new file. Right here, it's called Common Customer Questions Answered, and it's a .agent file. This behaves like any other file type within SharePoint. You can apply different policies. You can set different sensitivity labels. Here, I could click on this dropdown, and you have all the same actions you would have for any other file type. Now, I don't know if that many of our retail employees will come in to interact with the AI within SharePoint, but I do know they're going to be in Microsoft Teams. So I want people to be able to interact with this agent directly from Teams. How do we do that? Well, over here, I can click on the share icon, and here I can copy a link to this agent. Alternatively, over here in the right-hand side pane, I'll click on the three dots, and here we have a number of different actions, and here I can copy a link for Teams. Let's click on this. It looks like the link's been copied. Let's now head over to Microsoft Teams. I'm now in Microsoft Teams in a new group chat. Down below, I'll type in a message, and then let's paste in the new agent that we just created. Here, it recognizes the agent, and in the bottom right-hand corner, let's click on Send. Right up above, we can see the agent. Let me click on Add to this chat. Now that I've added the agent to this chat, down below, anyone can interact with this agent. To interact with it, simply type in the at symbol, just like you would when you're at mentioning anyone else, and then start typing in the name of the agent. And here I see common customer questions answered. I'll click on this. And now I can type in my question for the agent. Let's say, was customer order 1010 to Alex Martin delivered? And over here, let's send that. It looks like it was delivered. Now, the really cool thing is it pulls information from the SharePoint site in its responses. And now everyone on the whole team has access to the responses. And here it even references the document where it found the answer. All right, that was a quick look at SharePoint agents. Let me know in the comments if you're planning to create your own SharePoint agent. Now, if only I could have an agent reply to all the comments on YouTube, that would be a game changer. To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.